Hello friends, this is Vivek Kumar Sharma, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Information Technology, Arya College of Engineering and IT. Today I am here to represent the topic Machine Learning and Introduction. So the term Machine Learning can be defined as Machine is Learning. Machine is Learning. So that is the combination of two words, machine and learning. Then what is machine? Machine is nothing but that is a thing which reduces human efforts and make work easy, accurate and efficient. Now learning. Learning is the process of converting experiences into expertise or knowledge. Whatever we learn that age based on our past experiences are new things. Learning can be used in terms of machine learning on the basis of Bates shyness theory, in which rats learning to avoid poisonous whites. Now, in the real world, we are surrounded by humans who can learn everything from their experiences with their learning capacity. And we have computers and machines which work on our instructions, but can a machine also learn from experiences or past data like a human does? So this is the role of machine learning. Now what is machine learning? Machine learning, that is, in the real world we are surrounded by humans who can learn everything from the experiences, as I have already discussed. Now suppose a human who learns from the past experiences in the same manner, we just apply this phenomena on machines. A machine can learn or not. A machine can improve the performance on the basis of previous data sets or not. A machine can do better on the basis of previous results. That is machine learning. So machine learning is the subset of artificial intelligence. It is mainly concerned with the development of algorithms which allow a computer to learn from the data and past experiences on their own. It was introduced by Mr. Arthur Samuel in 1959. Technically, the machine learning definition can be defined as machine learning enables a machine to automatically learn from data, improve performance from experiences, and predict things without being explicitly programmed. It means there is no need to program again and again. It will behave on the basis of previous experiences, previous results. So what is the difference between artificial intelligence and machine learning? As I have already told in previous slide, machine learning is the subset of AI and deep learning is the subset of machine learning. So AI is a bigger concept to create intelligent machines that can simulate human thinking capability and behavior. Whereas machine learning is an application or subset of AI. Whereas machine learning is the subset of AI. On a broad level, AI and ML are the part of computer science that are correlated with each other. These two technologies are used for creating intelligent systems. How does machine learning work? Machine learning works on the basis of previous data, that is historical data, builds the prediction models, and whenever it receives the new data, predicts the output for it. This is the building block diagram. In this, we are providing input data and we are training the model, or we are training a machine by applying some machine learning algorithm We have so many number of algorithms like KNN algorithm. Then it will make some logical models, or it build some mediating thing by which it will produce output, and at the time of producing output we provide some more data. In case if we divide machine learning in further slide, there are three type of machine learnings, that is supervised, or I should say that is the type of machine learning: supervised learning, unsupervised learning, reinforcement learning. So we provide the data in the form of labeled data, that is already defined data or systematic data, by which machine can produce effective outputs. Features of machine learning. Machine learning uses data to detect various patterns in a given data set. By using this concept, machine, when we provide various type of or huge amount of data set to the machine, it detects various patterns. Now it can learn from past data and improve automatically. Machine learning, it is a data driven technology, and it is the part of, or it is much or more similar to data mining. Why? Because we consider huge amount of data. As much as huge amount of data we will use, our output will be more efficient, more accurate. What is the need of machine learning? The importance of machine learning can be easily understood by its use cases. Currently, machine learning is used in self-driving cars, cyber fraud detection, face recognition, friend suggestion, Google Assistant, Alexa, Kondara, Siri. Various top companies such as Netflix and Amazon have built machine learning models that are using vast amount of data to analyze the user interest and recommend product accordingly. Suppose when we search some product, first time I search a product, and next time when I will again search the product, the intermediate or the platform will recommend some same type of product from the different companies, from the different prices, and so on. So following are some key points which show the importance of machine learning. It is used for solving complex problems which are difficult for a human, for rapid increment in the production of data, for decision making in various sector including finance, finding hidden patterns and extracting useful information from data. This is the machine learning life cycle. There are total seven steps to complete the process. Machine learning life cycle is a cyclic process to build an efficient machine learning project. The main purpose of the life cycle is to find a solution to the problem or project. So in the complete life cycle process, to solve a problem, we create a machine learning system that is called model. So first of all, we have to create a model. That model is created by providing training. The model is created by providing training. So these are some steps. The first step, that is gathering data. Without data we cannot do anything, that is machine learns from the data. So that is the first part. Data gathering is the first step of the machine learning life cycle. The goal of this step is to identify and obtain all data related problems. Data can be collected from different sources such as files, database, internet or mobile devices. Now after gathering the data, the second step is data preparation. After, when we need to prepare it for further steps, in this step we put our data into a suitable place and prepare it to use in our machine learning training. Now The third is data wrangling. It is the process of cleaning and converting raw data into a usable format. It is the process of cleaning the data, selecting the variable to use, and transforming the data in a proper format. It is not necessary that collected data is usable always, as in real world data may have various issues like missing values, noise, invalidation, duplicacy. So we have to consider all these things. Now the fourth step is data analysis, that is, cleaned and prepared data is passed on to the analysis step, and this step involves selection of analytical techniques, building models, review the result. This step starts with the determination of the type of the problems, whereas we select the machine learning techniques such as classification, regression, cluster analysis, association, etc. The next step for the machine learning, that is train model. In this step, we train our model to improve its performance for better outcome of the problem. We use data sets to train the model using various machine learning algorithms. Then we test the model. Once our machine learning model has been trained on a given data set, we test the model. In this step, we check for the accuracy of our model by providing a test data set to it. So, testing the model determines the percentage accuracy of the model as per the requirement of project or problem. And the last step is the deployment. We deploy the model in the real world system, but before deploying the project, we will check whether it is improving its performance using available data or not. So these are the seven major steps in the life cycle of machine learning. So we have some various applications on machine learning. As we don't think in our real life, we are using so many applications like Google Maps, Google Assistant, Alexa, Siri, etc. Here, by this image, we can see some applications like automatic language translation. Automatic language translation can be used for various type of recognition system or translations like Google Neural Machine Translation translates text into our familiar language. Medical diagnosis, to build 3D models for brain, examine brain tumors or other brain diseases. Stock market trading, that is the up downs, share, long short term memory neural network is used for the prediction of stock market. Online fraud detection, online transactions to find fake IDs, fake accounts, to detect this feed forward neural network help us to check transactions. Next is virtual personal assistant like Google Assistant, Alexa, Cortana, Siri help us in finding information using our voice instructions. Email spam and malware filtering. In this, multi-layer perception, decision tree, name-based classifier algos are used for email spam and malware filtering. Self-driving car, Tesla, car company using unsupervised learning to train the car model to detect people and objects. Products recommendation, online shopping, Amazon, Netflix, they recommend all the products. Traffic prediction, in this application, we consider two things like real-time location and average time has taken. It takes information from the user and sends back to its database to improve the performance. Speech recognition, image recognition, that is search by Google Assistant, Siri, Cortana, Alexa, automatic friend tagging system in Facebook. So this is the all over life cycle of machine learning. Now here the classification. There are three types of machine learning: supervised learning, unsupervised learning, reinforcement learning. We will discuss these type of all the learnings and their algorithms in coming slides. So that was the small introduction about machine learning. Thank you.